sports. It's in the game.
Something we've only seen less than a handful of times since his franchise was born back in the 90s, and that's Jacksonville hosting in the playoffs as we welcome you to TIAA Bank Field. Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game, and we've got a great one in store between our visitors and the Jacksonville Jaguars. This one fielded at the 5. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. The start he was hoping for there as he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain on the game's first play, and it's second down now.
Second and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Over, over. 58, right over there, right over there. Yeah, yeah. Mike, 58, right there.
Oh, you got it.
Off the play fake. Here's Dobbs. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he had been able to haul that one in.
They come up to the line now facing a 3rd and 10 after the incompletion. On play action, it's Dobbs. And that will be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complimentary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
A run there on 1st down and a pretty good one at 5 yards, so make it 2nd and 5. It was Taven Bryan who got him down defensively.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down, a very solid gain on that play.
The 1st down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's the first carry for Northwestern's Justin Jackson. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a 1st down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Jackson, and he'll push forward for about 4 up to the 23.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down, a very solid gain on that play.
At the 23-yard line.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
All day, every day, any day. Check safety, check safety. 22, check.
On 2nd down, this is Jackson. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
2 straight 4-yard runs, and it is steadily working the ball downfield. To me, they're staying right on schedule. 1st down, you want 4 yards or more to set up the rest of the drive. They're getting exactly that.
And the Jags have 5 in the secondary here on 3rd down. Out of the gun, it's Taylor. Gets the throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage, too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down. Thank you. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll indeed go for it. It's Taylor. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. Just one catch for him last week in the wild card win, but getting involved early here and picks up the first.
I know they got the first down, but Brandon, I still don't like the call going for it there. Yeah, they got it, but I would have punted the ball there, played some field position. I mean, it's okay to end drives in kicks, right? You know, we've heard that from different guys before. Remember, a kick's either a punt, right? Field goal, or a point after touchdown. It's okay to end it in a kick.
They run on first down with Jackson. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And that'll make it 2nd and 12. From the gun, it's Taylor. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Sidney Jones. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Now Leonard Fournette. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down. On 2nd down, here's Fournette. Calling a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 5.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. Boy, that's a 5-yard loss. 4th down now.
Not the result they were looking for there on 3rd down. End up taking a loss on the play. The only person happy now, the punter, gets to go out there and show mom that he gets to play in the game.
Here's Logan Cook now as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. That'll be out of bounds, and how good was that? They'll say the 3-yard line. That's where they spot it.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. They go with Irvin to start the drive. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Brings up 2nd and 5 at the 8 yard line.
We're scoreless after 1. Charger football to start quarter number 2 as they are looking at a 2nd and 5 situation. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. They run the counter. It's Jackson, and the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of 1 yard, and it'll set up 3rd down.
And it's 3rd down.
And the Jags with 5 in the secondary now on 3rd down.
By 50, by 50. Get it,
from the shotgun. It's Taylor. He gets it to Brown. Complete. First catch for him in these playoffs. He was held without one last week, but he's got a first down on that effort.
A Hall of Fame coach once said, there are no medals for trying. And that wasn't a trying effort, was it? That was a winning effort. How about that great catch?
Excellent. They know, hey, you lose this game, you get a ding or two, you got 7 months to heal. They're going to go all out. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Jackson. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. There for the tackle, the former Wisconsin Badger, Leon Jacobs.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Now it's Jackson. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down. On third down, Taylor going deep for Hopkins. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant it a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all, and let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
In your face.
Check, 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 check. Check, check, check.
And he'll be taken down at the 18. It gets them a little over half of what they needed. Now they're looking at a 3rd and 5.
Anytime the offense shows what they call a shot play or a chunk play where they're trying to get big yardage, sometimes people just call it gadget plays, and you hold it to a gain that we just saw there, you feel pretty good about yourself as a defense.
An extra defensive back on the field for the Chargers now on 3rd down.
6 guys. Check 6 guys.
Big stop, G. Big stop. Let's go. 58's the money.
This is Fournette. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Bit of a surprise. They ran it on 3rd and medium. Proved to be the right call. 1st and 10. On 1st down, Dobbs to throw. Oh, did he hang on to it? He did on the dive. Nice grab. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post-route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend.
Come on, fellas.
We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. Fournette, a 1st down carry. A gain of 3, second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7.
A 3-yard pickup brings up second and 7 at the 42-yard line.
You got tight right there. Whip. Watch the whip.
And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Completes it to Westbrook, and he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for him. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
Move those chains. That's good for another Jacksonville first and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Set. 58 to Mike.
Ball.
Let's go. Five on. Chance.
Dobbs looking to throw on first down. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. Shotgun give to Fournette. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And finally, taken down at the 15. A Jacksonville first down on a pickup of 17. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. And into the red zone now, and Charles, they told us offense in the red zone was a focus this week in practice.
A huge priority, and the key was to get points, so you know that all the time during the week they talked about executing, taking care of the football, no big mistakes, make sure they put points on the board and come out of it with that.
That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
I think the best offenses love to give the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. Nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. On third down, Fournette. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. The ball's still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run, so now a little soul-searching on fourth down. So it's on to halftime of this AFC divisional round matchup. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports halftime report. Win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Let's go.
The Charger drive about to get going. And we thought this game had the potential to be tight. Maybe not this tight. Scoreless as we start the third quarter.
And I love the way you use the word tight. I'm going to take it a little bit different direction here because it's not just tight on the scoreboard. I think both offenses have been tight in how they've played this game. No one's been loose. No one's been free. They've got to find a way to make some plays, and I don't think you do it if you're really tight in everything that you're doing in the game.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They'll run with Jackson. Telvin Smith that time there to make the play.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Second and six. At the 44-yard line.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. They'll run again with Jackson. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. From the gun, Taylor. And he's got his man, Marquise Brown. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 24-yard line.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball, you must have a lot of confidence or you think you're really going to fake them out. And it looks like they did exactly that.
Yeah, going deep in the playbook and a great grab on the other end. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. On the run, this is Jackson. He's got the first down inside the 10, and he's in for a Charger touchdown. 24 yards as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Well, these two teams battled through a scoreless first half. Finally, a breakthrough here in quarter number three.
And I just wonder how that played for both of them psychologically, because when you battle through a scoreless first half, now you know that every possession is increasingly crucial. Who can put points on the board, make the other team chase? Wonder if you get a lift and if they get deflated a little bit.
And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line.
At their own 24-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down seven following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
He's coming. Double up, double up. He's coming, double up.
Dobbs is throwing. And this one into the hands of DJ Shark. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well.
That's good for another Jacksonville first and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Shut up. Watch the ship.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory. Denzel Perryman there to bring him down.
Tough first half for him. Unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Off play action. Dobbs. That one complete. He finds Shark. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into an either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
Now Fournette, and an alley to run. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
They keep it with Fournette on first down. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 11 more on that one, and another first down. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
And a little bit of space there, takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Give him 4 on the carry there, it's second and goal.
Brings up second and goal.
They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. And just one man in the backfield here. That's Kamara, second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A 3-yard touchdown run. As they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Extra point right down the middle. And we are tied at 7. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Charger drive about to get going. And these two teams have traded touchdowns so far with their first possessions here in the third quarter. So we're right back to where we started at intermission.
Yeah, how about that? Tied at the half, tied after the first two drives of the third quarter, one for each. That tells me that someone's defense has got to step up and make a big play and try and change the momentum of this game.
One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. The Chargers on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. On 3rd down, this is Jackson. And an alley to run. He's at the 4. The 20, 10, touchdown LA. Justin Jackson, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Chargers have taken the lead. They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was, and if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket, doesn't it?
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And it's a unit last drive that did it all on the ground, Charles.
And they controlled it from the interior, big on big, right? Offensive lineman versus defensive lineman. But, you know, in order to keep the football moving downfield, other people have to get involved as well. Your wide receivers, your tight ends, lead runners, anything that you have possible to get in front and keep the ball moving.
And now the defense may be looking out for a pass coming up. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The former number three pick, Joey Bosa, bringing the lumber that time. The following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing. Because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
It goes as a gain of eight that moves the chains. On first down, Dobbs flush to his right. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Jamie Collins able to get him down behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of a yard. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Here's Dobbs to throw. He goes full extension and he's got it. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one a first down.
And not all spectacular catches are the result of a pass that maybe was not thrown quite right. Sometimes it's thrown in the perfect spot, and you have to just go get it. He did that right there.
No fear there in the middle of the field. So first and 10 now from the 30. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. Joey Bosa in on the stop. Off the play fake. Dobbs. The open man is Westbrook. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12. Two important parts to that play. One, you get a first down, obviously, Charles. Two, managed to get out of bounds.
Love the way you dissected that, but he threw it in the middle of the field, so they picked up the first down, but he had to work his way to the sideline to stop the clock. What a great effort.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Shart's got it, left side. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen, did not let him get downfield.
On second down, Kamara. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
Don't be mad. There's more coming. There's more where I came from.
So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll bring up fourth down. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. Game on the line, season on the line. They're going for it here on fourth down. They'll go with a big bang for that. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. From the 2 now, second and goal. They'll run it with Kamara. And yes, he's into the end zone. So they get the late score they needed. And now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down 1. That extra point is not a gimme.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This will be taken very short. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Second down now. It's Jackson. Now third down is looming. A pickup of 2 on first down and just 1 yard there. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. Third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now it's Taylor. Got a man, it's Brown. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the fourth. Here's Taylor. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Keenan Allen, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. He was covered by Stephon Gilmore. Taylor incomplete on first down. Here's second and 10.
Tight end right, tight end right.
You got three. Three down, three down.
26, Mike, 26.
Throwing now is Taylor. He's going deep for Brown. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. Brings up third down.
Third down and 10 yards to go.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And they're out of timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. That's going to set them back 5 yards. After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. On is the Chargers punter now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Gets it away, and I don't think Peterson will get a chance to touch this one, angling for the sideline. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it, and they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. Overtime in a playoff game, awesome setup. Remember, the rules the same as they would be in the regular season.
That's exactly right, Brandon. Remember, the receiving team, if they score a touchdown, game is over. But if they kick a field goal or don't score, the other team gets a chance to get the football. They get a possession. If they go down and score, they win the football game at that point. If both teams kick field goals, we keep playing. If a defense scores, let's say the receiving team gets the ball, doesn't score, or they throw a pick six or fumble, gets picked up, the defense scores, game over. But here's the best part. In a regular season, only one period is played. We could call it a tie. Here, we're going to play until we have a winner.
The Charger drive about to get going. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. So first and 10 now from the 30.
What's the run? They're running it. Check, check. Let's go. Turn on.
Watch twist. Watch twist.
Alert flare. Alert flare. Flare, flare.
They'll run with Irvin. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7.
Here we go. 44th of Mike. 44th of Mike. Check, check.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home, yo. Let's make these babies cry.
First throw in overtime now for Taylor. It's complete to Hopkins. No gain that. Time on the completion, and it'll be 3rd down.
He's taken out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
What will they draw up to try to keep this opening drive of overtime moving? 3rd and 7. This one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 15 yards on that one and a Charger first down. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He's had some big runs in this game. Not there, though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game. And how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped, yet turn it into something big on a later carry? I'd stay with him.
On 2nd and 11 now. Taylor, he'll get this to his running back. It's Justin Jackson. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate
big plays for an offense.
Bro, I seen it in that. The first time I seen it was a 3rd and 7. He going motion snap. I'm like, wow, bro, this what we doing right now?
And they need 5 yards on 3rd down here to keep this opening drive of OT alive. Taylor will throw. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line. Finding his way home for the sack that time, Taven Bryant. On is the Chargers punter now. On for a very important punt here in overtime. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is 3, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it, but they turned it back over to them, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
Yeah, part one is done, now part two. Here's a 2nd and 5 now from the 25. Again, it's Fournette. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. That one, a 1st down pickup of 8.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
So a good run by Fournette. Now another 1st and 10. To throw is Downs. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's caught inside the 20. And he's going to score. It's a touchdown. No flags. And in an overtime thriller, they are moving on in the playoff.
No rest. They get to keep playing.
So they stay alive in the NFL playoffs, move on to the conference championship. And do you think that the printing press is starting to get those T-shirts and hats ready, my friend?
They have to, Brandon. They have to be ready, because if you win, you've got to hand those out on the field right away. And just think about the pressure for the players now. Families are going to be talking about tickets to the Super Bowl even before you play the conference championship game.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Jaguars are winners here as we say so long from Jacksonville.
I'm killing myself, nigga. So I ran the dive. I said, yo, let me see. And I said, I'm gonna run the dive, get the 1st, and I'm gonna go no huddle. And he did the same fucking shit. Bitch ass down, man. Go. I seen that shit. I said, oh, it's game over. Get with that Paul Pierce. I call game, nigga.